Good evening and welcome to Resurrection. Our opening hymn is Praise to the Lord, number 207. 207. Please stand.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Oh, my soul, praise Him, for He is your help and salvation. Come all who hear, now to His altar draw near, joining in glad praise to the Lord who shall prosper our work and defend us. Surely His goodness and mercy shall daily attend us. Ponder anew what the Almighty can do. With His love doth befriend us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We celebrate the 19th Sunday of Ordinary Time. So, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks. For your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth. Peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
To those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ. I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in hearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all. God bless forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Your words, O Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After he had fed the people, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said. And they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Every year, the diocese asks each parish to have a weekend which highlights certain ongoing missions in the world. This year, we were given the opportunity to learn more about and support the Mary Mother of God Mission Society, which does mission work in Russia. We will be taking up a second collection this evening. The first collection will be for regular giving and tithing, and the second will go to support the Mary Mother of God Mission Society. Sharing with us this evening is Marilyn Wassmer, whose brother Myron is president of the society and is residing in Russia. Marilyn?
Good evening. My name is Marilyn Wassmer, and I've been a longtime member of Resurrection Parish. In fact, we even went in the old church before this one was built. Some family history about our family. My brother and I, we grew up and we were born in a house on 65, just about 3 miles from here. The third house on the right going north past Keebler Road. just about a half a block from Fernbacher's Cabinets. Of course, our home parish is St. Joe, so there's four kids in our family. We all attended St. Joe Church and school. We all graduated from Modern Day High School. My brother went on to graduate in 1959 from Modern Day, and then he attended Evansville College, where he earned a bachelor's degree in sciences. And then from there, he went to IU, and he student taught for a year. He taught physics and math. And then he entered the priesthood, or he entered the seminary. And during that time, he went to Cornell University in New York, where he earned a master's degree in physics and astronomy. He was ordained a priest in 1972, and he taught those subjects at the college level for many, many years. Now about Russia. Russia's the largest country in the world. It has 11 time zones. Now, if you will, an imaginary map of this being Moscow and St. Petersburg and Ukraine, where the war is going on, you go all the way around the globe to the southern, easternmost part of Russia, and there you'll find the city of Vladivostok. It is on the Sea of Japan. It borders North Korea and China. Today, it's about a city of 600,000 people. Now, if you all remember your history books, some of your history, I know, you know the Russian Revolution started in 1917. Russia was a very Christian country for over 900 years. So the communists took over, and they wanted a country without churches and without God. Well, you can tear down churches. You know, they did tear down thousands and thousands of churches. But you can't take God out of here or here. So they tried. So in the city of Vladivostok, there was a huge church. It was a cathedral. And so why didn't they tear that down? Well, because it was a newly constructed parish. And so why tear down a new building? So it wasn't even finished yet with the construction. So they confiscated the church. They constructed two floors in it and turned it into the state archives, where it was used all during the war. Well, at the end of communism in 1991 and 92, my brother went to Russia at the request of a handful of Catholics who wanted a priest and who wanted to hear Mass and go and receive the sacraments. He went over there and he said the first Mass on the front steps of this church. It was so cold that he said Mass with hat and gloves on, because Vladivostok is on the same latitude as like Detroit and Chicago. It's on a large body of water and it's up high, and so it always gets the cold wind. Well, now it took them over a year to get the church back from the hands of the government. And then they had the monumental task of tearing out the floors, and which was the people that done construction work were few and far between. They had to get a lot of Chinese people to do that because the Russian people didn't really know how to do all this construction. So during all this time, my brother traveled extensively throughout the whole region, and he established 11 parishes wherever there once was a parish. And so he would like rent a two-room apartment and get someone to run the watch over the place, and then once a month he would visit that and have Mass and give out the sacraments while he was there. Well, my brother had to advertise on radio and TV and in the newspaper that there was a Catholic priest there in Vladivostok. But the people were so afraid. They lived in terror their whole life. Three or four generations lived in terror, where you were killed because you were a believer. So the people didn't come out at first, but gradually they started coming in. Today the parish is flourishing. And so once people started coming to the church, then my brother started what they call Cateris, or it's our equivalent to Catholic Charities and St. Vincent de Paul combined. And so they take food boxes to the elderly Most of the elderly live in six-story apartment buildings with most of the time no working elevator, so they have no way to get out and get their food or medicine. So the food box consisted of flour and sugar and cornmeal and powdered milk and powdered eggs and canned meat and medicines and stuff. So that is an ongoing thing today. Another thing that he started was he supports three orphanages and also three hospitals. The hospitals are nothing like what's here. They're like a real small nursing home, but they are considered a hospital. And so the mission, the church bought them hot water heaters and all the plumbing that went with that, and they bought them industrial-sized water heater washers and dryers. Can you imagine having an orphanage or a hospital with bed linens and, you know, and no hot water to clean them very good? So that's always an ongoing thing. Russia has two main social problems, and that is alcoholism and abortion. Most of the men in Russia are alcoholics. Vodka is very cheap, so most of them drink. And so he's got someone from the United States to go over and start AA and Al-Anon. So that is still ongoing today. And abortion. The average Russian lady has 8 to 10 abortions in her life. My brother says he has heard 18 in the confessional. So because of this huge problem, he got two doctors from Dayton, Ohio, and they went to Russia, and they took with them an older ultrasound machine, and they set up the first crisis pregnancy center to teach the women that abortion is wrong. You know, they need guidance and counseling, and that's what they help these women with diapers and formula and stuff. So today they have 7 centers opened up wherever they have a parish or in a hospital. And so they've saved over 4,000 babies from being aborted. You know, no wonder Russia's falling apart. No wonder they don't have a country, because they killed all their people. You know, Russia was the first country in the world in 1922 to legalize abortion on demand. And from 1922 to this year is 101 years, and they estimate that they have killed 600 million babies. Just think of that. That's just awful. So anyway, that's very back there on the table. I have a lot of literature that you could look at and see about the babies. My brother also started his own religious order by permission from the Vatican. He has 23 priests ordained in his order. There are 7 countries that they're in: America, Kazakhstan, Philippines, Indonesia. I can't name them all right now, but anyway, so there's 6 priests in the United States. There's 2 in Las Vegas, there's 2 in Madison, Wisconsin, and there's 2 in Gary, Indiana. So who knows, one day we might have one of his priests here in our diocese. You never know. So anyway, like Father said, there's going to be a second collection, and because of he has so many seminarians to educate, and it costs them like $10,000 to educate one seminary for a year. And here in the United States, it costs almost over $80,000. So you can see that's what we're taking up funds for, to help pay for the tuition and the expense of educating these priests. You know, he also has three sisters that belong to his order. They are from Missouri, and they are over there, and they man the Newman Center. There's a huge university in Vladivostok, and it has over 30,000 students, and there's a lot of students from different countries who are Catholic. So the Newman Center, they could go there and hear Mass and keep up with their Catholic faith in the Newman Center. So that's working out real well. I have a little story to tell you now. A few years ago, my brother spoke at St. Peter's Church in Hubstadt, Indiana. And my sister and I, we were in back of church, and we were greeting the people as they were coming out. And there was an older man that come up to us, and he had a real German accent. And he said he was a German fighter pilot in the war. He said that he was in his plane already, and his job was to bomb enemy places, drop bombs on enemy places. And he was in his plane. He had bombs. His plane was all loaded with bombs. He was in the air already. And at the very last minute, he was supposed to drop a bomb on that cathedral in Vladivostok. And at the very last minute, his orders were changed. And he had to go back to base. And he tried to find out why his orders were changed. He asked, and he just couldn't find out why his orders were changed until he heard my brother speak about the cathedral in Vladivostok. And Lord, there it is. He said, I'm quoting, "The Blessed Mother protected that church." So, I mean, that just kind of gives me chills. But anyway, I'm back there in the narthex if you all want to come and visit. So one of the other things, a little story, the Russians, they lived for three or four generations in terror of the communists. And recently, one of the bulldozers and the graders were making a new road around Vladivostok, and they come upon a mass grave with over 12,000 skulls in it. So that is not the only one that they have found. They found other ones that are had less amount of skulls, but just think of that. So when you come up to communion today, think about the Russian people, because my brother says when they come up to communion, the Russian people, the tears are coming down their faces, because they are so grateful to be able to receive the body of Christ. Are we that grateful? This is why you're here tonight. This is why you come to church, to receive the body and blood of Christ. So think about that. Be grateful and thankful that you live in America, where there's freedom of religion, and that you can hear to receive the body of Christ. You know, there's four kids in our family, as I said before, and every night we knelt down and we prayed the rosary as a family. And my brother and I, we're the two little kids, and my mother says, "Let's pray for the conversion of Russia." Well, we're two little kids. What does that mean? Those are big words. What does that mean? And in 1917, Our Lady of Fatima said, "One day Russia will be converted." And my brother has a huge part of that conversion. How awesome is that? And to think that someone that just grew up down the road here, a modern-day graduate, is in the far east of Russia doing this heroic and saintly work. I think that's awful. That's awesome. Thank you all for listening, and thank you, Father.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified.
crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us fix our eyes on our saving Lord and bring our needs to him.
For the church, may the hand of the Lord steady each of us across any stormy waters as we serve one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government officials, may God convict and equip them in working for justice for all people, especially the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are facing a trial of faith, may the Lord's gentle whisper and guiding hand be upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God give us the grace to follow him in all things. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all deacons celebrating their anniversaries of ordination this weekend, that they will continue to serve the church faithfully in their ministries of word, liturgy, and charity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they soon rest in eternal peace in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Sis and Jigs DeVault, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those intentions that we hold in the quiet of our hearts.
Good and gracious God, we know you can do all things. Hear and answer our prayers in your kindness and mercy. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Our offertory hymn is Be Not Afraid, number 438438.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, for you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you. Pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people, formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity,
together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in our communion song, The Supper of the Lord, number 337.
Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Share the supper of the Lord. This is the bread of God coming down from heaven, giving life to us, to all the world. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Share the supper of the Lord. I am the living spring of eternal life. You that drink from me shall not thirst again. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares a feast divine.
is broken now. Cup of life is poured.
Come share the supper of the Lord.
I am the bread of heaven, giving life to you. You that eat this bread shall never die. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Share the supper of the Lord. All those who feed on me, having life in me, as I have my life in the living God. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Share the supper of the Lord. All praise to you, O Christ, present in this feast. In this bread we share in one life one Lord. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Come share the supper of the Lord.
Please join in singing number 328, Ubi Caritas.
Caritas, Vespera, Vespera, Deus tibi est, Deus tibi est. The love of Christ joins us together, let us rejoice in him. And in our love and care for all, now love God in return. Ubi caritas, espera, espera, Deus tibi est, Deus tibi est. Into communion let us gather, may all divisions
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a reminder that this Tuesday, the 15th, is a holy day of obligation, the Assumption of Mary. We will have Masses on Monday night on the Vigil at 6 p.m. and Tuesday, the day of obligation, at 7:30 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. I'm sorry, 6 o'clock p.m. So that's Monday night at 6, Tuesday morning at 7:30, Tuesday evening at 6 for the holy day of obligation. Religious Ed registration forms are due next Sunday. Paper copies can be found in the church narthex this evening. The forms are also on the homepage of the parish website. Our next monthly adoration is this Thursday from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. here in the church. Just a reminder, we are offering Eucharistic adoration the third Thursday of every month this school year. And you may have heard in the prayers of the faithful that our deacons have got an anniversary coming up. 1 year tomorrow, Deacon Dan and Deacon Ed will have been ordained 1 year. 1 year. Let's give them a hand for all they do. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you. The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks
be to God.
Please join in singing number 564, All the Ends of the Earth, 564.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures on the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Break into song at the deeds of the Lord, the wonders God has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Heaven and earth shall rejoice in his might. Every heart, every nation, call him Lord. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.